Hello students, how are you? So today we will start a new chapter of macroeconomics, that is government budget and the economy. This chapter is very important from examination point of view. So first of all, we should know what a government budget is. A government budget is an annual statement of estimated receipts and expenditure of the government over a fiscal year. But a fiscal year here means financial year, which starts from 1st April to 31st of March. So, I repeat, government budget is an annual statement of estimated receipts. Estimated means these are not actual figures, because government budget is a plan. It is made for future, not for the present. So government budget is an annual statement of estimated receipts and expenditure of the government over a fiscal year, which runs from 1st April to 31st of March. So I think it is clear. Now, budget has two components. So the two components of government budget are, as you can see here, capital budget and revenue budget. So capital budget and revenue budget are two different components of government budget. Now we'll start with capital budget. Now capital budget has two different components. One is capital expenditure and the other is capital receipts. You all know expenditure means outflow of money and receipts means inflow of money. So capital expenditure is basically expenditure which either increase asset, or decrease liability of the government. Now we shall consider an example. Suppose there is purchase of building by a government. Now if government purchases building, so building is an asset. So there is increase in asset and there is expenditure also. Therefore this expenditure is correct, capital expenditure. Now repayment of loan. Suppose government had taken loan from World Bank or IMF or from public, and government repays that loan, which means repayment of loan. Again there is expenditure, but there is decrease in liability of government. Government ki liability is kam ho gayi kyunki unhone apna loan pay off kar diya. So this expenditure is capital expenditure. So capital expenditure means that expenditure which either increase asset or reduce liability of the government. So you can get one more question from this, ki why purchase of building is regarded as a capital expenditure. Then you write, purchase of building is capital expenditure because it increases asset of the government. Now we come to capital receipts. Receipts means money आ रहा है गवर्नमेंट के पास. सो कैपिटल रिसीव, जस्ट चेंज दीज साइंस, इट इधर रिड्यूस एसेट और इंक्रीज लाइबिलिटी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. सो व्हाट इज कैपिटल रिसीव? कैपिटल रिसीव मींस दैट रिसीट ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट व्हिच इधर रिड्यूस एसेट और इंक्रीज लाइबिलिटी. नाउ एज यू कैन सी द कंपोनेंट्स आर borrowings and other liabilities. So if government borrows, how can government borrow? It can borrow from RBI, from IMF, International Organization, International Monetary Fund. It can borrow from World Bank or from public. Government issues bonds. In all these cases, liability of the government is increasing. So increase in liability, it is a capital receipt. Now second is recovery of loans. तो व्हाट इज लोन, इज इट एन एसेट और लायबिलिटी? सो इफ गवर्नमेंट हैज गिवन लोन्स, ग्रांटेड लोन्स, देन इट इज एन एसेट फॉर द गवर्नमेंट. इट इज लायबिलिटी फॉर दोज हु हैव टेकन लोन्स, बट फॉर गवर्नमेंट इट इज एन एसेट. नाउ गवर्नमेंट रिकवर्स दैट लोन, वो लोन रिकवरी कर ली, वापस ले लिया, तो क्या हुआ बच्चों? रिकवरी ऑफ लोन से एसेट फॉल हो गया. दिस क्राइटेरिया इट इज अगेन अ कैपिटल रिसीट. नाउ थर्ड कैटेगरी इज अदर रिसीट्स. अदर रिसीट्स इंक्लूड डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट एंड स्पॉन्सरशिप्स. नाउ व्हाट इज डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट? डिसइन्वेस्टमेंट इज जस्ट ऑपोजिट ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट. Now suppose there is a public sector undertaking or a government enterprise and government sells the shares to public, then government is getting money, at the same time it is disinvesting its share. Disinvesting its share, that means capital receipt. Shares for government are assets, there is reduction in asset. Now small savings. Government keeps small savings in the form of NSC, etc. So these small savings are liability of the government, liabilities are increasing. So I think this capital budget is clear to you. It has two components, capital expenditure and capital receipt. Capital expenditure, either asset increase or liability reduces. Capital receipt, either asset reduces or liability is created. Now we move on to the second component, that is revenue budget. Revenue budget, capital budget ka just opposite. That means under capital expenditure there were either increase in asset or reduction in liability. Here neither asset is increasing nor liability is falling. For example, payment of salary. गवर्नमेंट का डिपार्टमेंट है, गवर्नमेंट पेज सैलरी टू इट्स एम्प्लॉयज, बट ड्यूरिंग दिस पेमेंट ऑफ सैलरी नीदर एनी एसेट इज इंक्रीजिंग नॉर एनी लायबिलिटी इज रिड्यूसिंग. हियर लायबिलिटी मींस लॉन्ग टर्म लायबिलिटीज. लायबिलिटी मींस लॉन्ग टर्म लायबिलिटीज. सो दीज पेमेंट्स विच आर रेगुलर और रेकरिंग इन नेचर दे आर क्लासिफाइड एज रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर. नाउ रेवेन्यू रिसीट्स, व्हाट आर रेवेन्यू रिसीट्स? Which neither reduce asset nor increase liability. Now these revenue receipts, they are very important component of government budget, and they can further be divided into two parts: tax revenue and non-tax revenue. Tax, you all know, tax is a compulsory payment which is made to government by public and firms. And all the revenue receipts which are not tax revenue are obviously, yes, non-tax revenue. So, tax revenue, first we'll talk about this. Tax revenue, taxes can be classified as direct tax and, yes, indirect tax. Direct tax, what is direct tax? If the burden of tax and liability to pay tax is on same person, that means you cannot shift the burden of tax, then it is a direct tax. For example, income tax, house tax. अगर मेरी income पे tax लग रहा है तो मैं आपसे तो नहीं मांगूंगा. I have to pay that. It is direct tax. Direct taxes are imposed on income and property of persons and firms. For example, income tax and house tax, all other taxes which are imposed on goods and services are indirect tax. Example, VAT, excise duty, sales tax, GST. अब आपको बताया all the indirect taxes are merged into one tax, that is GST. But from examination point of view, different examples of indirect taxes are also very important. Now we come to non-tax revenue, fees. Fees of government schools and colleges, it is also source of revenue for government. Fines and penalties. These fines and penalties are imposed for infringement of law. Yes, you will not use breaking law, you will use इन्फ्रिंचमेंट ऑफ लॉस, बिना हेलमेट के गाड़ी चला रहे, बाइक चालान कट गए, सीट बेल्ट नहीं लगाई, दिस इज ऑल सोर्स ऑफ लिविंग फॉर गवर्नमेंट, बट द मेन पर्पज इज टू मेंटेन लॉ एंड ऑर्डर, द मेन पर्पज इज नॉट टू अर्न रेवेन्यू. नाउ इज चीप, इट इज क्लेम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ओवर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ पर्सन, क्लेम ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ओवर प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ अ पर्सन हु डाइज विदाउट एनी लीगल एयर एंड विदाउट लीविंग अ विल. अगर किसी व्यक्ति की मृत्यु हो जाती है और उसने अपनी कोई वसीयत नहीं बनाई है, उसका कोई कानूनी वारिस नहीं है, तो प्रॉपर्टी कहां जाएगी? इस गवर्नमेंट, गवर्नमेंट ट्रेजरी, दैट इज नोन एज एस्टेट. नाउ फोर फीचर ऑफ बेसिक श्योरिटी, यू कैन ऑल्सो राइट फोर फीचर ऑफ बेसिक सिक्योरिटी. व्हाट इज फोर फीचर मीन? फोर फीचर मीन्स जब्त कर लेना. अगर आप शेयर्स पे कॉल मनी पे नहीं करते तो गवर्नमेंट जितना मनी पे किया फोर फीट कर लेती है. सेम फोर फीचर ऑफ बेसिक श्योरिटी, इफ यू एंटर इनटू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट विद गवर्नमेंट एंड यू डू नॉट फुलफिल द कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, यू डू नॉट कंप्लीट इट, देयर इज सम सिक्योरिटी, देन गवर्नमेंट विल फोर फीट इट. इट इज ऑल्सो अ सोर्स ऑफ रेवेन्यू फॉर गवर्नमेंट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन विल डू difference between capital expenditure and revenue expenditure and capital receipts and revenue receipts. That is all for this session. Thank you.